We are super excited to announce that we've significantly updated the shapes in Power BI. This update includes a lot more new shapes, more formatting options, a new default styling, and the ability to upgrade any old shapes within your report. Before we dive into the details, I want to give a big thank you to Ethan Netz. He was the contributor that helped build the shape component from the ground up. This was his first time developing as a contributor for Power BI, but we're thrilled to say that he'll be joining as a full-time developer, so you'll for sure see more of his features in coming releases. So now let's get started and see what's available with these new shapes. To add these new shapes to your report, simply go to the Insert tab in the ribbon and then select the Shapes dropdown. Here you'll see a lot of shapes to choose from. You have some common rectangle shapes, basic shapes, as well as block arrows. So in this case, I've added several different shapes to kind of show you what's available, as well as showing you the types of formatting options available. So let's dive deeper in terms of the new formatting capabilities. So a big one you'll notice is that we've added text options. And this is really useful because we know that in the past, in order to get text options on a shape, you're essentially having to create a shape and then you add a text box on top of it. And we know that that can be a real pain and also adds more elements that you need to manage on the report. So we've simplified that experience by adding a text formatting option on the shape itself. So you can access that in the format pane under text. And you'll have a lot of options here, including font color, text size, font family, as well as some alignment and margin options. Next setting we want to look at is rounded edges. And even though we had rounded edges in the old shape visual, in the previous experience, it was tied to the outline setting. And that caused some issues because, let's say, if you didn't want to have an outline, but you still wanted rounded edges, that was not possible. However, in the new experience, we've added this setting within the Shape tab so that it's no longer tied to whether or not you have the outline turned on. Next thing we want to talk about is the shadow formatting. So previously we just had shadow available for the entire visual container, but if you didn't have shapes that filled the full container, the shadow would look not exactly encompassing the shape. So in this case, we've added a shadow that is available on the shape, and you can find this under the shadow tab right here. And you'll be able to control the color, transparency, blur, and the preset as well. Next, similar to shadow, we have a setting called glow. And so in this case, we can open up this tab here called glow. And it's very similar, except you'll see that glow is all around the shape like this. And you can also customize, similar to shadow, the transparency and the blur. And then the last formatting setting I want to talk about is rotation. And before, we also had rotation, but it didn't have a lot of granular control. But in this new experience, you'll be able to control the rotation of the shape and text together as a whole, or just the shape, or just the text alone. And so that kind of gives you a lot more granular control of the rotation of both the text and the shape. The next thing I want to talk about is that we've also updated the default styling. So let's say if you are changing the theme, so I'm going to go ahead and just pick some different theme colors. You'll see that the styling of the shapes have actually changed. So they're attached to different parts of the theme, specifically your data colors align with the shape. So you can see here, if I'm changing the colors here, the shapes change differently compared to the old shape experience, so the old styling of the shapes. One more thing I want to touch on before we move on to the next section is that when you have old shapes in your report, converting is very simple. So in this case, there's an older shape right here. And you'll notice when I click on it, I have the option to convert this to the modern design. So when I go ahead and click convert, we'll get this dialogue that asks me if I want to upgrade all of the shapes in this report at once. I can check that. If I just want to upgrade the shape, I can click convert. Also note that you can always multi-select shapes on the same page if you want to convert multiple at the same time. So let's go ahead and convert. Notice that you may need to readjust the shape after you've converted it because the older shape did have a little bit of padding between the sides of the shape. So that's it for the update on shapes. We really hope that you like this new capability, and as always, we really appreciate any feedback that you have.